This is the demonstration of the next version of the swept path simulation inside of PyFlow. In this scene we have a path. This may be a road. And we have here a car model. And we want to analyze how this car runs over this road. So I have here node which simulates this, and I can here say I have 60 simulation steps for the whole curve, and here I have a step 0, and now I can start driving the car, and this way I can look how it runs along, and this is the graph. We have here in this some nodes. The first one here is the destruction shape for sketch 1. Sketch 1 is the car, and the points of the car are useful to get the borderlines where the car can drive on. And the second one is here a reference to the sketch, and I have a selection, in this case the H1 of the sketch on this point, and both objects are input pins of the swept node. The track points come from the car, and the path comes from this reference object, and furthermore I have the number of steps here, and the simulated step. In this case we have 60 steps, and we have position 28 here in this picture. And from the swept node we have some outputs. First is the car. Where is the car on position step in steps, in the number of steps. The next is the tracks. What are the tracks of the points? And we can see this. I have here the tracks outcome. That means for each of these vertices I track the flow. We can see this when I drive here along with the car. I always see here the points on these curves. And the last object I calculate is the flow axis. The flow axis, I use the line from the top of the car. This point goes along the path. And here is the center of the axis of the wheels, this point. So, and I can track them, and we see the result here. These are the axes. So, and now we can see what happens if we reduce the whole image down to, say, only 6 simulation steps. We see here 6 steps. The model is very simple, and we see this is not enough to get a good simulation, and we can go furthermore to 60. Then we get this picture, and we also can go up to 600. Then we get this, and in this case we have a good approximation, and I can have a look at the running time. In this case, if we have 600 steps, the whole simulation runs in 0.1 seconds. This is fast enough. And when I run the car, I see here the way of the car, and we have here the fine fine details. We have all the curves, the fine curves of the track points. We have the axis in each situation, so we can see how the direction of the car is, and we have the simulation of a car here too. And this is all now inside PyFlow, done with this one node with two inputs, the car and the path, and these three outputs. And if the outputs are not required, the program will become a little bit faster too, but I think it's fast enough.